With new highly efficient engines, an extended wingspan, and various new upgrades, the Boeing 777X will be the next new wide-body aircraft to enter the market. At the time of this video's production, Boeing's website states that there are unfilled orders for 481 777X airframes across its three variants, the -8, -9, and Freighter. 10 passenger carriers have ordered the 777X, many of whom are operators of the quote-unquote original 777. For these carriers, the 777-8 will serve as an ideal replacement for older Boeing 777-300 and 777-300ER airliners, while the 777-9 will be the closest successor to legacy jumbo jets like the Boeing 747 and Airbus A380. But how, specifically, will the new aircraft fit into most carriers' long-haul fleets? Moreover, which airlines have ordered the 777X as a jumbo jet replacement, and which see its future as a successor to aging 777s? Let's try to answer all of these questions for today's video. Well, a great place to start is with the three major Middle Eastern legacy carriers, Emirates, Etihad Airways, and Qatar Airways. These airlines have already placed large orders for the new aircraft. Etihad has ordered 25 777X jets, Qatar Airways nearly four times that amount at 94 airframes, and Emirates with the largest number of 777X aircraft on order with 205 units. The order is relatively straightforward for Etihad from a fleet expansion perspective. The airline has mostly ordered the 777-9, the larger of the two variants. These jets are more than likely to replace the carrier's A380s. Qatar Airways' 777X order is split between 777-9 and 777-8F variants, with 777-9s being more than twice the freighters. On the passenger side, the new widebody will replace the carrier's Airbus A380s while allowing some higher-capacity 777s to retire. For Qatar Cargo, which already maintains a young fleet of 747-8F and 777-F jets, the 777X will expand the carrier's long-haul freight capacity. The Chief Executive Officer of Qatar Airways, Badr Mohammed Al-Mir, in a press release stated, "Qatar Airways is proud to announce an expansion to the existing Boeing 777X aircraft order with an additional 20, totaling 94 Boeing 777X aircraft. We, as the world's best airline, are an industry leader and operate one of the youngest fleets, offering unparalleled innovation and quality." For Emirates, which currently maintains a fleet exclusively comprised of Airbus A380 and Boeing 777 aircraft, the future flagship will likely be the 777X. For this reason, the carrier has placed a massive order split between 777-8s to replace aging 777s and 777-9s to replace its Airbus Super Jumbos. Last year in November, the airline almost doubled its order of the 777X to 205, making history with an additional $52 billion deal. On its recent order adjustment, the airline stated, "These additional aircraft will enable Emirates to connect even more cities, supporting the Dubai Economic Agenda D33 set out by His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum to add 400 cities to Dubai's foreign trade map over the next decade. By the early 2030s, we expect the Emirates fleet to be around 350 strong, connecting Dubai to even more cities around the world." One last note about the 777X and the Middle East 3 group of airlines. There hasn't been much discussion about whether or not these large Boeing jets will offer the same ultra-high-end product as the A380. This is particularly the case for Etihad and Emirates and their first-class offerings, as well as Etihad's higher-than-first-class three-room suite product known as the Residence. Will the 777X be configured with onboard shower or lounge as seen on some Middle Eastern A380s? Or will lounges and onboard showers die out as the A380s retire? It probably doesn't matter to 99% of those watching this video, but the concept of showering at 35,000 feet was certainly an interesting talking point when discussing Airbus's double-decker. But moving on. Other carriers that have placed orders for the 777X, such as Singapore Airlines, Lufthansa, and British Airways, are also eagerly waiting to begin taking delivery of their first jets. These carriers have also been long-time operators of the Airbus A380 and will need new large jets to fill this capacity segment after the Super Jumbos retire. Germany's Lufthansa, for example, is rapidly expanding capacity and has reactivated many of its largest aircraft, the A340-600s and A380s. Keeping these less efficient jets in service is an interim measure until the 777X arrives. Air India, Cathay Pacific and ANA are the three 777X customers yet to be discussed. While ANA does fly three Airbus A380s for high-volume service to Hawaii, these three airlines primarily operate older 777 variants. One would expect these airlines to place orders for the 777-8 to replace those aging 777s. However, the carriers have surprisingly all committed to the larger variant, the 777-9. One of the main explanations for this is that the 777-9 is much, much closer to entering service than the 777-8. Indeed, we'll likely see the 777X freighter enter service before the passenger variant Dash 8. The common thread across all of the airlines mentioned in today's video is that they are mainly hub-and-spoke operators, funneling traffic through one or at most two airports. It's London Heathrow for British Airways, Hong Kong International for Cathay Pacific, Singapore Changi for Singapore Airlines, and the list goes on. The 777-9 will allow these airlines to provide capacity on their busiest and most popular routes, while also having the space to install some extremely high-end premium products. For the latter, we'll undoubtedly see fully enclosed first-class suites with floor-to-ceiling doors, and perhaps even space for a guest to share a meal. We would imagine that some airlines will make room for lounges. After all, Virgin Atlantic, with its A350s and A330neos, offer social spaces on board for premium passengers to gather. But it's an entirely different situation for American carriers, who don't seem to have any interest in the 777X. United Airlines Senior Vice President of Global Network Planning and Alliances Patrick Quayle recently spoke to Business Insider about why his airline isn't ordering the 777X. The airline executive highlighted the multi-hub style of operations in the United States, explaining that the carrier prefers smaller aircraft that are easier to fill. Quayle was quoted as saying, "Everything is out and everything is back, and it's all through these massive connecting complexes. The reason American, Delta and United didn't order the 747-8 or the A380 is for this very situation and that the traffic is fragmented and splintered." In the interview, Quayle pointed to the airline's operation at London Heathrow, highlighting that the carrier operates from all seven of its hubs to the English capital, demonstrating the spread of its network across its US facilities. "We're not taking people from the West Coast, flying them to the East Coast and then flying to London. We're flying non-stop from the West Coast, non-stop from the mountain region, non-stop from Houston and Chicago, and non-stop from the East Coast," Quayle stated. In this regard, aircraft like the Boeing 787-9 or Dash 10 will be better sized for such operations. On the flip side, the high-capacity 777X doesn't make sense. But what do you think of the role of the 777X in the fleets of various airlines around the world? Do you think we'll see the same onboard amenities on these new Boeing widebodies as can be seen on some A380s? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.